Hello, I am Nick of In the Nick of Time.
So your mission wasn't a complete failure.
Besides the soldier,
this movie shot, is the third part to Chemical, and ironically, it is the middle part of this episode, which is actually a movie. Chemical is really a movie put in three parts. And the reason why this scene is kind of laggy was because of technical difficulties and laziness.
We were on our way back to the lab to find out how this all happened.
I'm just way too lazy. I should redo filming and stuff, but I just don't like to. It would make the movie 10 times better, but I don't know. Fuck it. That's my whole thing. Fuck it. This was written by me a couple years ago. And it's been taking a couple years to finish, so yeah. This guy right here, not the guy in the Warthog, but the guy outside the Warthog, he is voiced by a dear friend of mine, Dark Seda. And he is hardly ever on Xbox Live because apparently he plays WoW and has a girlfriend, I think. I don't know. Now, the guy in that horrible Hayabusa armor is another dear friend of mine. Westnader, and Westnader lives in Georgia.
Make sure he doesn't get
fooled. He's like really cool. In the beginning of this episode, or this part, was Quick Tactical, the overlord of Epic Films. They make really good movies, and I'm really glad that I got him to help me out. There's a whole history behind Epic Films and me that I could go into right now, but that would just ruin this commentary. Anywho, this scene actually, I shot it twice. The first time I shot it, I don't know what happened. Like, oh yeah, I forgot to save it. Like, we did the whole scene, and I just forgot to save the thing in theater, so I had to redo the whole thing, and everyone in that scene was not in the credits the first time. So, yeah, I should get up there.
Behind you.
Another little thing I'm glad is this next voice about to come up that's me talking to. He is voiced by one of the guys who did an excellent machinima that was like 30 minutes long, called Suicidal Heroes Part 1 or Episode 1, I don't know. And it is fantastic. I order you to go see it after you watch. Listen to this commentary.
Yes. While cycling through my iPod, I came across
he also did the voice of all three scientists in this part. He did the voice of this guy.
That's not the song.
And then the last scientist you're about to see, it's like in the end of the episode. Now this scene, like, was inspired by Hero vs. Villain. If you haven't seen Hero vs. Villain, it's a short, like, 5-minute skit little series. Like, I started thinking of random little things that could happen in Chemical, and this was one of the little random things. And the other stuff that didn't seem to fit in Chemical, I kind of worked around to Hero vs. Villain. Like, the first two episodes of Hero vs. Villain are kind of related to Chemical in a way that they were supposed to be in Chemical, but they couldn't fit anywhere. And there's another technical difficulty thing. In this scene, there is no ambient noise because while I was recording, I was in a party chat with a bunch of my friends, and I like to have the chat, the voice going through speakers and the headset, so I don't know what my friends are looking at, but they're on the internet looking at, like, this website that had recipes for cooking, but the main ingredient was like sperm, and like and then see they were laughing about making cake instead of using milk, they use sperm, and I don't know, it was just weird. Now a lot of continuity errors in this, in that Sergeant Harrison is actually in the scene when he isn't. He's supposed to be inside the base. Another continuity error that's about to come up is that turret is about to get exploded, and later on you'll see the turret is actually fine. Like right there, the turret was blown up, and pretty soon the turret will appear back. That was a huge continuity error on my part, I'm sorry. And another thing I apologize is the shaky camera. I went out of control with this shaky camera. I don't know. See that Sergeant Harrison right there? I just couldn't help myself. Shaky camera is what I do. This was the last thing we filmed. Like this battle scene right here was the very last thing we filmed. And I'm gonna be honest, I think I filmed it about 3 weeks ago. This scene. 3 weeks ago from this commentary was the last time we shot. We filmed Chemical Bar 3. And it just shows the balance between firepower of the Gold and Green Army.
Why is it that we get all the grunt work?
This is not grunt work.
But this was another little boring thing that I thought about. Like,
shut up. Let me shoot something.
This was Smitty, one of the things that worked.
Fine.
Like, it. I almost didn't put it in. Like, this guy running up going, oh, I'm gonna fucking kill you. I almost didn't put this in. I almost made this another Hero vs. Villain episode. But it actually, this one actually pretty worked. Worked really well for this scene.
You're loud.
Just fucking shoot him right now.
I
noticed that whenever somebody dies in this part, the only one who makes their own like like death noises is me. Nobody else does that. I don't know why. I should. Maybe it's because I don't tell them to. Now this, I'm trying to find someone that will do the voice of Gus. That's why he doesn't have any. He's supposed to have dialogue in here, but he doesn't have any because nobody did it. I wanted Brian. I want someone else other than Brian to do it. Because Brian is lazy because he will only do something if he's into doing it. Like, he will only do voiceovers if he feels like doing those voiceovers. And ironically, he never feels like doing voiceovers. So I'm trying to find someone new to be the voice of Gus. And if you're listening to this and would like to help out in the series, send me a message.
Hiya, Bobby.
Hi, Ken.
You wanna go for a ride?
And another error here. This song is not by the Spice Girls. It is by Aqua or something, I don't know. So I'm sorry. Aqua and the Spice Girls. Oh, Captain Sid is the guy from Suicide Heroes, and I swear to God, I don't care if you stop watching this to go see Suicide Heroes. That is just fantastic. I mean, I could not tell you in words how amazing that movie is for a machinima. I just love it. I don't, like, it's 30 minutes long, and I've probably seen it about 10 times. That was Ghost 147, and he is from Canada. He created Canadamation, and he has been, like, laying me low. Okay, quickly, if you'd like to help out with the movie, send a message to me over YouTube, email me at brianandnick@yahoo.com, all one word, spelled exactly like that. My YouTube account, send me a message over AIM, which is XBrianNickX, and send me a message over Xbox Live, which is In The Nick Of Time. And if you just want to help out, or just, like, say hi, and say how well you like the movies, anything, just do something so I have motivation to do this. Please.